What's up, guys? I'm back. It's James Brady. I'm excited. I'm pumped up, ready to give you guys some knowledge and some wisdom. Look, guys, I really appreciate all of the responses that I get. I appreciate all the support. And believe it or not, I appreciate the ones that don't support me. You know why? Because it makes me feel like Rocky. You know, I'm constantly fighting. I'm constantly pushing. And the ones that got their eyes open, I'm here to help you do the same exact thing. So just want to share a little bit of information with you. Just a little bit. All right. So pay attention. I'm going to give you a little bit of information. I want you to let it sink in your head. Let it resonate. And then decide what you're going to do next. Okay? So, first things first, I want to let you know that until the pain of remaining the same becomes greater than the pain of change, you will never see change. Let me repeat that for you one more time. Until the pain of remaining the same, meaning until you get so tired of being where you're at, until that pain of being where you're at becomes greater than the pain of just being a little different, the pain of doing something different and going against the grain a little bit, until that pain gets bigger, you're never going to see change, because you're always going to be scared and you're going to always stick to what you think you know. But guess what, guys? There's a better way. There's more out there for you to do. There's more money to be made. There's more people's lives to change, guys. So this is what I want you to do. I just want you to be open-minded while I talk to you for a little bit. A couple things that I really want to go over that's been on my mind lately. You know, I was on a conference call about a week ago, and I was listening to one of my mentors speak, and, you know, he gave us a secret, and the secret's out there. You want me to tell you the secret? Listen, I'm going to tell you the secret. Guess what? Success leaves clues. You didn't hear me. Success leaves clues. Yes, it leaves clues. Open your eyes to pay attention to what's going on around you. There's successful people everywhere. If you want to be successful, all you have to do is start making different decisions, okay? You have to look at the people around you that are doing better than you are and see what they're doing a little bit different than you are, okay? And then start to make the same decisions that they're making. You don't have to do the same thing as them, but understand that their mind state is in a different mind state, and it's helping them create massive success. So all you got to do is figure out just how to imitate that person a little bit and kind of make your own with it. You know what I mean? Take what somebody else is doing, kind of do it the same way, but throw your own little twist and just make sure you do something different. That's the biggest thing. Make some different decisions. All right. So I just want to let you know that what my mentor said was, every single decision, every single action, every choice you make is either getting you one step closer to success or one step closer to failure. One step closer to success or one step closer to backpedaling. One step closer to freedom or one step closer to being back in jail. Okay? One step closer to sobriety or one step closer to being addicted again. Come on, guys. It's decision-making season. All right, we are grown now. This is not the early 2000s anymore. Most of my friends and family that I grew up with around, we're 20, 21, 25, 28, 30. Come on, guys, let's get it together. Let's make some better decisions. You got it in you. I know you got it in you. You won't find it in you to make those different decisions. But I want to give you a couple examples. My mentor, Darren Hardy, gives a couple examples in his book, The Compound Effect. And he even gave me a good example when we were in Las Vegas. And the example is this: a horse race, okay, you know horses, right? A horse wins a race by just a nose, okay? So just, I want you to think, a horse is racing, one horse is one nose ahead of the other one, but he gets 10 times the amount of prize money, 10 times, okay? That doesn't mean that that horse is 10 times better, that doesn't mean that that 10 is 10 times faster, it doesn't mean none of that, it just means he's a little bit better. So what I want you guys to focus on is just be a little bit better, okay? Nobody's expecting you to just turn into a miracle child overnight, because that stuff doesn't happen, okay? What you need to do is focus on progress, not perfection. Just be a little bit better. Just be a little bit better than you were last week in your relationship or in your spirituality or in your job or in your workout or in your eating habits or whatever, in your speech, the way you dress, your vocabulary. Just be a little bit better than you were yesterday and the day before. And if you constantly strive on making the decision consciously to be a little bit better, you're going to see 10 times the amount of results in your life because you're doing it always. You're constantly making that decision, so you're constantly progressing, which means your constant momentum is going to take you into different places in your life that you've never been before. Trust me, I know. The second example that Darren Hardy gave me personally when we were in Las Vegas was, you know, the difference between a Richter scale. Okay, the Richter scale is what's going to determine how bad an earthquake is. You know, what actually determines how what's going to fall off of your walls. You know, that type of thing. So the Richter scale 5.0 just says that, okay, it's going to knock a couple things over. It might shake your table a little bit. And then if you go from just a 5.0 to just an 8.0, well, 8.0s are devastating everything. I mean, if an 8.0 hit right now, this video would be over, like right now. So just think about 5 to 8. We're talking about 3. 3 points that it went up, and it went from just knocking a little glass off the table to knocking the whole entire building down. Okay, so that's the power right there. Just a little bit of difference is going to make a massive, massive effect in your life. But you got to believe it, and you got to push towards that. So the smallest decision that you make, anything, the smallest decision that's a positive and a good decision that you make consistently and consciously will change your life because it's a compounded effect. You make that decision over and over and over and over and over and over again. Before you know it, you're in a whole different stage of your life, buddy, but that's what it takes. It takes those small decisions constantly over and over and over again, guys. So make the better decision. I'm encouraging you. Make that better decision to leave those friends alone that aren't no good for you. To leave that job that's stressing you out when there's people out there that'll pay you more money because you're worth more. You know, don't sell yourself short. Make the decision, okay? It's up to you. You are the captain of your own ship. Okay, the only difference that's going to determine where I get and where you get is the sale, okay? The mindset, what you're thinking on a constant basis. You're thinking that negative all the time, well, guess what? You're going left somewhere. You're thinking positive, you're going that way. You see what I'm saying? It's all a mentality, it's a mindset and a decision. You have to make the decision though, okay? So, you also have to keep your options open, all right? When you're making decisions, you have to understand that the person that you are now isn't the person that you want to be, you know, 3, 4, 5 years from now. So keep your options open so that you can grow, okay? I'm going to tell you one thing. The most expensive thing that you can own is a closed mind, okay? Because a mind is kind of like a parachute. It only works when it's open. If your mind's not open and it's closed, then guess what? You're going nowhere fast. And you can actually look behind you and see that having a closed mind has got you to where you are right now. So be open-minded. Look for opportunities to try different things and maybe mess up a couple times. So what? You have to fail to get better. Stop being scared of failure. It's a part of the system of success. Remember, I told you, success leaves clues. Nobody hits the target once and just nails it. You gotta mess up a couple times. So get uncomfortable. Do something that you never did before. You know, just make sure that it's legal and safe and all that type of stuff. But please do something different. You do the same thing, you get the same results. It's easy, it's very simple, but you have to make the decision. So before I leave you, before I let you go, I wanna leave you with just two quotes, all right? Two of them. I want you to remember these, all right? So first one is by John C. Maxwell. I want you to think about this. Anyone can steer the ship, but it takes a leader to chart the course. All right? Anybody can steer the ship, but it takes a true leader to chart the course. So what does that mean? Anybody can be successful once at something. Anybody can make a good decision one time, but it takes a true leader that is going to decide to get from where they're at into the destination. And not mean I'm halfway there and I'm tired of driving, I'm tired of steering. No, we're going to get all the way there. That's what a leader does. It's nonstop, okay? All the way till you get there. So that's one quote. The second quote is, this one's by Jim Rohn, another one of my mentors. Says, you cannot change your destination overnight, but you can change your direction overnight, all right? So you might not be able to change everything going on in your life in one night. You can't do that. It's because you've already made too many of those other decisions that have compounded and got you where you're at right now. So what it's going to take is just to make that decision to change direction, start making those different decisions, and watch your life go into a whole nother place, okay? I promise you, it will happen. I believe in you. Guys, this is James Brady. I truly love you. Even though sometimes you guys might get annoyed with me, I don't care, you know, because somebody's out there that's listening to this and they're growing and they're becoming a better person. And that's what my goal is, to help as many people as possible. And I can help you too, but you still got that kind of closed mind. So as soon as it opens up and you're ready, you get with me. I want you to look at the bottom of the screen and you can see the link, www.jamesbradyonline.com. Or if you just want to make some extra money and do something on the side and you don't really like what you're doing for a living right now, I want you to text "hate my job" to 55469. All right, you guys have a blessed night. I'm gonna have a blessed night. I will see you on the beaches of the world, and if not, I will definitely see you at the bank. See you later, gentlemen and ladies.